So hopefully you have already done this. It's a simple thing, coordination number three, right? So it is basically just simple geometry. If you do the simple geometry, then the structure is done. You just draw three large atoms and the smaller one touching them, and you are done, right? So let us see, right? So this is your basic drawing. If the coordination number is three, then three large ones which are touching each other, and one small one which is touching all of them. So this is very simple. Now you can draw these lines. Of course, this is one radius, the other radius of the big one. So this is 2r, this is 2r, this is 2r, they are equal. And from the center of the small one to any of this line, from here to here or here to there or here to here, right? So now this is the distance from here to here. So if you take now this, and I draw only from this to this to this, only this triangle, and we have enlarged it. So from here to here is one capital R, right? From here to here is one capital R, one small r, right? Radius of the big one, radius of the small one, right? Capital R, small r. So this total distance is R plus R, and that is it. And because this is an equilateral triangle, right, all sides are equal, so the angles are 60. So if you are taking the half angle, then the angle is 30. So this is now, that is it, right? This is now it. So now you can do any simple calculation. If you take this side is capital R, this side is R plus R, right? So if you say cos 30 is R upon R plus R, and cos 30, you know the value. So from there, one line, two line, and you are done, right? So you draw the geometry. If it is coordination number of three or coordination number of four, draw the basic geometry, draw triangles or this and that, and then you are done, right? So we are just showing you. You can quickly go through this, that AD is R plus R, cos 30 is so much, take, right? So R upon R plus R is 0.866. Take this on the other side, 0.866 R, this, that, redo the calculation. And once you have, right, 0.866 small r is equal to 0.134 big R. So a small r upon big R is 0.155, right? So those numbers that were there on the tables, that if it is a coordination number of three, the minimum critical radius ratio should be 0.155. It is no rocket science, very simple, that take one radius to be small r, take the other radius to be capital R, do small geometry, and this is it. If it is 0.155, then they are all touching each other. If it is less than 0.155, then the small and the large atoms are not touching each other, and then there it will be unstable, and so on, right? So you have done this, earlier, you have repeated it, but now you are doing this. Remember, you are doing this for a ceramic. Earlier, you were doing this type of a calculation for a pure metal, when we were doing crystal structure for metals, it is iron or chromium or aluminum or whatever, then all the atoms are the same atoms. Here, one of the atoms is the larger atom, one of the atoms is the smaller atom, one is cation, one is anion, one is metal, one is non-metal, right? Whatever you say. And but the way you are doing the things is still the same. Let us do one more problem, right? Again, we are doing the simple AX type, AX. So this is now CCM chloride, 1 to 1. Ionic radii are already given. Ionic packing factor, right? So you can go back, remember, atomic packing factor. When it was a pure metal in crystal structure, all atoms were the same. We were calling it atomic packing factor. But because here it is CCM chloride or sodium chloride, so there are two types. So there are ions of one and the ion of the other. So the ionic radius of one is given, the ionic radius of the other is given. Atomic packing factor, remember, was the volume of the actual atoms in the cubic cell divided by the volume of the cubic cell itself. So this time it will be volume of the ions, actual ions, divided by the volume of the whole cube. So please, again, do it yourself, right? pause my lecture here. Very quickly do it yourself by the definition, and then go and see the solution. Then you are always stronger. If you directly see the solution, then it is weak. So if you are listening to me now, after the pause, then you have already solved it. Okay, so let us see. So I am just showing you the CCM chloride structure. The CCM chloride structure, it is the BCC structure, right? BCC. Corner ones are one type and the central one is the different one. And here, for example, it is like this, that the central one we are taking as a CCM, for example, and all corner ones are the chloride, right? All corner ones. So if it is this one, then this is the cube. This is the cube. And because it is body-centered cubic, body-centered, so we are not making the diagonal on one face, right? We are not making the diagonal on one face. If it was face-centered, then we will make the diagonal on any face. Any face. One type of atom, another type of atom to the third. But here it is body-centered. So we are making diagonal of diagonal, right? From this corner to that corner. That is it. That corner to this. So this is it. Now, if you take the base, for example, base. Only the base. Only the base. Then this is A. This is A. If you take the diagonal, if you take the diagonal of the base, it is by Pythagoras theorem root 2A. But we are taking the diagonal of the diagonal from here to here. So now you have this triangle. Triangle from here to here to here. Right? This. So the base is root 2A. This height is A. So a square of this, a square of this will be equal to square of this. So you will find that this length is root 3A. Do you understand, right? That the diagonal of the base face is root 2A. And this is simple A. So when you have this triangle from here to here to here, then by Pythagoras, a square of this plus a square of this is equal to square of this. So by doing that simple, you find root 3A. So root 3A is this length, and this is actually equal to, if this is the big R, then 2 big R and 2 small r, right? So 2 small r plus 2 big R equals root 3A. So this is it. Now, once you have done this, then you can do any calculations, right? So this is one side. Now, what is the volume of a cube? Volume of a cube is A cubed. Volume of a cube is A cubed, right? A cubed. So find what is A. You have root 3A is equal to 2 small r plus 2 large r. From there you can find the small a, and whatever that small a is, cube that, you have the volume of the cube. And in BCC ceramic, how many equivalent atoms are there? Equivalent atoms. We just told you that there is one big central atom and 8 corner ones. So the small one is 8 into 1 by 8, which is still 1. So there is one small and one large. So 2 of them. So there are 2 equivalent atoms. What is the volume of a sphere? 4 by 3 pi r cubed. So 4 by 3 pi r cubed for the small one, 4 by 3 pi r cubed for the large one. Add them. This is the volume of the actual ions. And you have already found A cubed, the volume of the total cube, and you now can find the atomic packing factor. So we are doing just this, that root 3A is equal to 2R plus 2R. So 2 a small r, 2 large r. From here A is equal to 0.405, right? So A cubed will be 0.405 cubed. And 4 by 3 pi r cubed for CCM and 4 by 3 pi r cubed for chlorine. For CCM it is 0.17, for this it is this, right, upon A cubed 0.68. The ionic packing factor for CCM chloride ceramic is 0.68. So now this is brilliant. I don't know if you realize that when we were doing simple crystal geometry for pure metals, then for body-centered cubic, the atomic packing factor was 0.68. Now we are doing a body-centered ceramic. body centered ceramic. The two atoms or ions are very different in size, right? No, close to CCM chloride is the same column, same column. So it is 0.17, this is 0.181. Not too different, not too different, right? If it was, say, calcium, something else, right? Sodium chloride, for example, right? So it would be maybe different and so on, but so 0.68 was the atomic packing factor for pure metals, which were BCC type, and 0.68 by this calculation is the ionic packing factor for a ceramic, which is the AX type, the CCM chloride type. So now, if we have done one example on finding the atomic packing factor, you can do any other examples, right? So this is the beauty that, right, you can, so for any one of them, now, whether it is CCM chloride type or sodium chloride type or zinc blend type, right? All of those, the atomic packing factor will be similar. Find simple geometry, whether it is body centered or face centered or whatever. Find the relationship between a small a and capital R, a small r. Find the volume of the cube. Find equivalent number of atoms in the cube or ions in the cube, and 4 by 3 pi r cube for each one of them, and do the atomic packing factor, right? So you can do any of those. So what I'm saying is that because you have done basic crystal structure, so you can do atomic packing factor, you can do density, right? Volume density, planar density, linear density. Remember, in the beginning, I showed you one or two or three slides that how do you find a direction, right? So if it is linear density, it will be the length of a line upon something. If it is planar density, it will be area of a plane upon something. If it is normal volume density, then it is simple volume density. So any of these problems or something like show that the coordination number and the radius ratio is this and that, all of these now you can do. We have done some examples here. You have solved examples from your earlier course. So please, right, you know that in any chapter, the questions are the understanding of the structure and so on, and the other questions are the numerical ones. You like the numerical ones more because, right, you can actually do some calculations. The descriptive ones, you have to understand and answer, and then there are some multiple choice, true, false, and so on. So whatever we cover, the numerical part is this, right? And you can apply all these numericals to any of the types, right? Any of the types. If the geometry is given, then you can proceed from there. So now let us go a little further. Perovskite structure, right? I told you, ABX type. For example, barium titanium oxide, calcium titanium oxide. So all of them are like this. The white ones or the gray ones are barium. The green ones are the oxygen. And the central one is the titanium. So this is like body centered. Right? This is body centered. But the other ones are arranged like this. So because there are now three types, three different materials, barium, titanium, and oxygen. So it is slightly different. But if the structure is given, then they are all there, right? So we are just explaining very quickly that this is the system. A metallic cation holding large charge filling the octahedral interstitial site. The other metallic cations fill the corners of the six faces. The anions occupy the face centers. This type of a structure is called a perovskite structure, depending on the person who was discovering this. And these type of ceramics are piezoelectric. This is big thing, that these are ceramics, these are not metals, but these ceramics behave in a piezoelectrical system where electrical current can change into mechanical stresses, or mechanical stresses can change into electrical stresses or voltages and so on. So these are very brilliant ceramics.